Okay students, good morning all of you. Our next topic continuation, salivary glands. Salivary glands. So yesterday we discussed about digestive glands introductory part. So the digestive glands are located in the wall of the alimentary canal. Those are gastric glands, Brunner's glands, crypts of Leverkun. Along with these, some other glands also, that is liver, pancreas, and salivary glands. These are also play a major role in the process of digestion. These are called extra alimentary canal glands. So first of all, let us see about these extra alimentary canal gland, that is salivary gland. Next, gastric glands. Next, intestinal glands, we will see that. So salivary glands. In human beings, there are three pairs of salivary glands are present. Three pairs of salivary glands are present in human buccal cavity. In those three pairs, first one is a pair of parotid glands. Second one is a pair of submaxillary glands, also called submandibular glands. Third one is a pair of lingual glands, a pair of parotid glands. These are present below the ear pinna. Near the cheekbone. Okay? So that is a pair of parotid glands. A pair of parotid glands are present near the ear pinna or below the ear pinna. So this is ear pinna, below the ear pinna or near the cheek cells. Cheekbone. Okay, that's all. Next, a pair of submaxillary or submandibular glands. These are present lower side of the jawbone. Next, lingual glands, a pair of lingual glands. These are present below the tongue region. Below the tongue region. So these three pairs of glands secretes two types of cells. These three pairs of glands secretes a type of cells. Those are called serous cells and mucus cells. Okay, ma'am?
That's right.
So these three pairs of glands together secretes two types of cells. Those are two types of cells. What is serous cells and mucus cells. Serous cells and mucus cells. So serous cells and mucus cells collectively produce saliva. Serous cells and mucus cells, which collectively produce saliva. Okay, so the saliva contains water, salts, mucin. It is also called tyline, and lysozyme. So these are all present in saliva. Okay, these three pairs of glands together produce serous and mucus cells. These two cells secrete saliva in our mouth or buccal cavity. So the saliva contains water. Our saliva contains water, salts, and mucus. Along with these, another one, salivary amylase, alpha amylase, tyaline, and lysozyme. So lysozyme which kill the bacteria. Which kill the bacteria? Okay, ma'am? Saliva. It contains saliva. Saliva contains water, salts, mucin, salivary amylase, alpha amylase, tyaline, and lysozyme. Lysozyme, which kill the bacteria present in our mouth, or else through the food, if any bacteria is entered, so those bacteria so destroyed by the lysozyme. The pH of the saliva is. The pH of saliva is 6.8. So pH means hydrogen ion concentration. Hydrogen ion concentration of the saliva is 6.8. The pH of the saliva is 6.8. Okay, so this is the explanation about three pairs of glands. Here one objective discussion, one disease that is called mumps. Mumps disease. The mumps disease is caused by the virus, that is paramyxovirus. Mumps disease, it is caused by the virus, that is paramyxovirus. This virus causes disease that is called mumps disease. In the mumps disease, the children suffers from painful sensation in parotid glands. These parotid glands becomes swelling, inflammation, and inflammation means painful sensation in parotid glands. So this disease commonly occurred in less than 10 years of children. Okay, that disease is mumps disease. It is caused by paramyxovirus. Suppose the children who are suffering from mumps disease, those people will get a painful swelling in parotid glands. Parotid glands. Below the ear pinna, parotid glands are present. These parotid glands becomes swelling and they will get a vigorous pain. On and off, they will get pain. So, okay, that's it. Okay, that's all. See here, that is the explanation about salivary glands. Next topic is gastric glands. Gastric glands. Gastric glands. See here, the gastric glands location. In the wall of the stomach, just beneath the surface of the epithelium. See here, we have discussed about stomach. This is stomach. So, what? Gastric glands. Gastric glands are located in the wall of the stomach. In the wall. This is wall. In the wall. In the wall of the stomach. Just beneath the surface epithelium, beneath the surface epithelium, it is called epithelium. Epithelium, it is called epithelium. Just beneath the epithelium, there is glands. Those glands are called gastric. These are called gastric glands. Gastric glands. Okay, so gastric glands are located in the wall of the stomach, just beneath the surface of the epithelium. Just beneath. So this is the epithelium surface. Just below the epithelium surface, gastric glands are present. There are three different types of glands. Types of gastric glands. There are three types of gastric glands are present. Three types of gastric glands are present. Okay, one type is caudal glands. There are three types of gastric glands are present. One type is caudal glands. One type is caudal glands. Caudal glands. Another one is pyloric glands, cardiac glands, pyloric glands, and third one is fundic glands, cardiac glands, pyloric glands, fundic glands. Fundic glands also called oxyntic glands. Okay, so there are three types of glands that are present. One is cardiac glands, second one is pyloric glands, and third one is fundic glands. It is you, fundic glands. So fundic glands also called oxyntic glands. So let us see, cardiac glands, it secretes mucus and gives protection. Cardiac glands secretes mucus and gives protection of the inner stomach place. Instead of the stomach. Next, pyloric glands. It is also secrete mucus. It is also secrete mucus and hormone gastrin. Okay, so pyloric glands, already we discussed it. It is cardiac portion, it is pyloric portion, it is fundus portion. Already we have discussed it. It is not new point. So cardiac glands secrete mucus and gives protection. Whereas pyloric glands secrete mucus and gastrin and hormone gastrin. And fundic gland or auxiliary gland. It consists of three different types of cells. Those three different types of cells are next cells. Fundic gland. In this region, middle fundic gland is present. The fundic gland consists of three different types of cells. Those are next cells, it secretes mucus. Second one is peptic glands. Peptic cells. So the peptic cells secretes large quantities of the proengines, pepsinogen and pro-renin. Okay, next cells secretes mucus. Peptic cells, it synthesizes large quantities of proengines, pepsinogen and pro-renin. Okay, so what is the functioning of these? In the process of digestion. So neck cells secretes mucus, peptic cells secretes large quantities of proengines, pepsinogen and pro-renin. Okay, that is peptic cells. Third type of cells is or auxiliary cells. Parietal cells are auxiliary cells which secretes hydrochloric acid. HCl. Third type of cells are parietal cells or auxiliary cells, which secretes hydrochloric acid. This hydrochloric acid is similar to the acid present in the chemistry lab. The concentration of hydrochloric acid present in our stomach, which is similar to the concentration of the HCl present in the chemistry lab. Okay, so the HCl and Costils intrinsic factors, which is essential for the absorption of vitamin B12. So B12, cyanocobalamin, vitamin B12. So costils intrinsic factor play a major role in the absorption of vitamin B12. The chemical name of vitamin B12 is cyanocobalamin. Okay, cyanocobalamin, that is vitamin B12. So it will be absorbed in the stomach. Vitamin B12 is important for our body. It controls the anemia disorder. It controls the anemia disorder. Some conditions, biconcave shaped red blood cells turn to be sickle shaped, abnormal shaped. In such conditions, cyanocobalamin vitamin will control changing the red blood cells into abnormal shape. That is the hormone, that is the vitamin is, not hormone, that is the vitamin name, B12. B12 is a common name. The chemical name of vitamin B12 is cyanocobalamin. It is very, very important to our body. Okay? Okay? So these are all the glands, pineal glands, pituitary glands, fundic glands. All these glands
collectively secretes juice that is called gastric juice.
That is called gastric juice. All the three glands collectively secretes juice that is called gastric juice. The pH of the gastric juice is 0.9 to 1.8. The pH of the gastric juice is 0.9 to 1.8. That is the gastric juice. So the gastric juice contains some amount of gastric lipase. Gastric juice contains some amount of gastric lipase,
which play a major role in the process of partial digestion of food material entered into the stomach. Okay, that's how the food is.
pH, one student is asking what is pH. Hydrogen ion concentration is called in our saliva. Some amount of hydrogen ion concentration will be there. In the stomach, whatever may be the juice is releasing, in that juice some amount of hydrogen ion concentration will be there. So in our body saliva, pH is 6.8. So pH of gastric juice is 0.9 to 1.8. Okay, so this is the explanation about the gastric glands. Ma, I am explaining one by one part. The physiology of the digestion is different. That is a separate topic of the discussion. Okay, I am explaining about the first, up to last class I have given explanation about the alimentary canal. Today I am giving explanation about digestive glands. In those salivary glands is finished. Now gastric glands finished. Intestinal glands yet to be finished. Okay? So that is the explanation about gastric glands. Let a note about gastric glands. It carries 5 marks question. At that time, 1, 2, 3 you have to write. About these 3 you have to write. Fundic glands or obstetric glands consists of 3 different types of cells. Those are neck cells, peptic cells, parietal cells and obstetric cells. About these function species. These 3 glands collectively produces gastric juice. Its pH is this. Okay, the gastric juice also contains some amount of gastric lipase. అది చక్క తీసుకొచ్చి పెట్టేసారు సార్. ఇది చాలా వెయిట్ ఉంది కదా సార్. Intestinal glands. Intestinal glands. Here there are two types of intestinal glands. Intestinal glands. In the intestinal glands, there are two types of cells. Two types of cells. One is. Grunner's glands. Second one is crypts of liver cone. Intestinal glands are two types. Sorry, ma'am. In the intestinal glands, there are two types of cells are present. Yesterday I said that Grunner's glands and crypts of liver cone. Grunner's glands secretes mucus. Grunner's glands secretes mucus. Okay, so along with mucus, Grunner's glands and the crypts of liver cone also secretes a kind of a juice that is called intestinal juice. And intestinal juice and succus entericus. Okay, ma? Two types of cells. One is Grunner's glands and crypts of liver cone. Initially, Grunner's glands secrete mucus. Along with mucus, this is and crypts of liver cone collectively secretes a juice that is called intestinal juice. It is also called succus entericus. The succus entericus with the pH ranging from 7.02 to 8.0. The pH ranging from 7.0 to 8.0. 7.0 to 8.0. The succus entericus. Succus entericus contains peptidases. Those peptidases such as dipeptidases, amino peptidases. Tripeptidases, dipeptidases, aminopeptidases, and disaccharides such as invertase. Maltase, lactase, dipeptidases, aminopeptidases, and disaccharidases. Disaccharidases are several types, such as sucrase, which is also called hematase, maltase, and lipase. Along with these, Sacca centricus also contains small amounts of intestinal lipase. What is the functioning of all these? The process of digestion of various kinds of food materials present in the stomach and intestine. Partially digested food material from the stomach to small intestine reaches. In the small intestine, the food is completely digested with the help of Sacus entericus. Sacus entericus also called intestinal juice. Okay, so this intestinal juice contains tripeptidases, dipeptidases, aminopeptidases, disaccharides such as hematase, maltase, lactase, and small amounts of intestinal lipase also present. Okay, that's all. Next, here in the small intestine, special cells that is called Paneth cells. These are lining the bases of the intestinal glands. These are lining the base part of the intestinal glands. Secretes lysozyme. Paneth cells. These covers the intestinal glands. Secretes lysozyme, which kill the bacteria. Lysozyme kill the bacteria, which escape the destruction in the stomach. Some of the bacteria destruction, killing, escaped in the stomach. Such kind of a bacteria in the small intestine definitely killed by the lysozyme, which kill the bacteria, which escape the destruction in the stomach. Okay, that is the topic. Next, the intestinal walls contain special cells. Intestinal walls contains special cells. Those cells are called stem cells, which play an important role in renewing or reproduce epithelial cells lost in the intestinal epithelium. If any epithelial cells are damaged or lost in the intestine, those cells are again renewed, reproduced by the stem cells. These stem cells are protected by the Paneth cells. These stem cells are protected by the Paneth cells. Paneth cells play a major role in the protection of the stem cells. The functioning of the stem cells in the small intestine is what? The intestinal walls contains specialized cells. Those cells are called stem cells. Those stem cells play a major role in the renewing of the epithelial cells lost in the small intestine. Epithelial cells expired, worn out. After certain days, existing epithelial cells are lost. In the existing epithelial cells, new one is renewed. The stem cells play an important role in renewing the epithelial cells lost in the small intestine. Okay, those stem cells are protected by the Paneth cells. Okay, so this is the explanation about digestive glands, salivary glands, intestinal glands, gastric glands. Along with these, other glands also is there. Liver, pancreas. These liver is the first largest gland in the body. Pancreas is the second largest gland in the body.
These two also will secrete, liver secretes bile juice, pancreas secreted pancreatic juice. These two also will play a major role. About these two roles, we will be discussing in next class. Okay, so some students asked and raised doubts. Those doubts, let's have look on them. First, Android Blue Droid. What is spelling? First, your name, with your name you log in, then you ask spelling. Okay, so I should not accept you. Many times I said, with your original name you would have to log in. Okay, so that you adjust. Next, Praveen. Annadini. Sir, goiter, ma. So the goiter is different. Mumps disease is different. The goiter, the simple goiter. The simple goiter is, okay, so the goiter is simple goiter disease. This is a hormonal imbalance. Thyroxin hormone, if it is a deficiency in human beings, then we will suffer from one kind of a disorder, that is a simple goiter disease. Okay, that is different, that is a hormonal deficiency. That's we will keep discussion on last part of the human physiology. Someone asked, sir, please send recorded videos. So daily I am uploading recorded videos except one day. On that day, so in my laptop recording was failed shown. It was too large to record it, it was shown. After that I was adjusted my app settings. Last word. What is the last word? Here, what is the last word? What is the last word? Last word spelling means what is the last word? That specific word you mention, then I get to know that. What last word means what here? Last word, panet, P-A-N-E-T-H, panet, here S-T-E-M stem cells, that only. Rather than that, what is the last word? I did not understand what is the question. Okay, ma, so daily I am uploading videos, there have a look and properly follow that. So you need not worry about these classes. Try to listen, try to understand. If not follow, no problem. When classes commences, so we will show on them once again brief revision. You need not worry. Okay, so that's Salma. Downside last word. Downside lysozyme. 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 Maltase. 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 Lactase. Invertase. Sucrase. Downside last. Intestinal lipase. Okay. Yes. It is a scientist name, that particular scientist identified. So such kind of glands names they will use. Bowman's capsule, kidney, Bowman's.